Good morning. Today is Thursday, December 10th, 2020. There's an important case being tried in court now. The challenge to Bill 21 taking place here in Montreal. Bill 21, passed by the Quebec government last year with wide popular support and vociferous minority outrage. Bill 21 prohibits wearing religious symbols by large categories of people in the public sector. Largely, it affects Muslim women. It also affects Jews and other minorities. I have loudly, frequently, and publicly criticized Bill 21, and I support the challenge against it going on in court now. Because this bill is a direct attack on freedom of religion, freedom of expression, the right to equality, and in an unprecedented step, Quebec set aside fundamental rights by invoking the notwithstanding clause to say that notwithstanding the rights in the Canadian and Quebec Charter of Rights, notwithstanding those rights, this bill will become law. And this is the first time that the notwithstanding clause has ever been used to preempt scrutiny of a law that directly targets fundamental freedoms. Now, the notwithstanding clause is a part of Canadian law. Everyone is entitled to their opinion of it, but this is a very serious issue for the following reason. The underlying question in this case is, does Canadian constitutional law allow the notwithstanding clause to apply in any situation, even in the face of human rights, religious rights, freedom of expression? And that is the argument of the Quebec government, the Attorney General of Quebec. Notwithstanding clause applies under any circumstance. The problem with that is, that means that there is no situation where a majority can be limited in enforcing its values on a minority once the notwithstanding clause is invoked, regardless of how significant the rights being denied are. The truth is that no Canadian court has ever had to face this particular issue. And so it's a very important case. And now, there is a side story threatening to divert attention from this case and this important issue. A cynic would say this is the intent of the sideshow to distract us. And that is, one of the lawyers arguing the case against the Quebec government has been accused publicly of drawing comparisons between Bill 21 and the Nazi Nuremberg laws, between Quebec and Nazism. Now, such a comparison would be wrong and odious and completely inappropriate. The lawyer in question is Azim Hussein, and he did not say that. Now, Azim is my friend. We've worked together on several projects. He is a brilliant lawyer. He is also very knowledgeable about Jewish law, which he studies regularly. The charge against him is a distraction from the excellent work he is doing on behalf of all of us. And all accounts have it that he is putting on a brilliant critique of the government side. Now, This is what he actually said, and it's an important issue, and it's important and worthwhile to understand it. What he said is as follows. He urged the court that when they consider Bill 21, they should consider what they are doing in allowing the notwithstanding clause to be upheld regardless of the law that it tramples. And the test of that will be what happens if there's a law worse than Bill 21. How bad does it have to get and still allow the notwithstanding clause to allow such a law? And the world should have learned from the Nuremberg laws of 1935 that the time to stand up to discrimination is when it is still not so extreme. So what Hussein suggested is that when the court analyzes Bill 21 today, it should consider the precedent it sets in case of a situation where the government wanted to come up with an even worse law, like the Nuremberg laws. Would the notwithstanding clause still apply in that case? At no time did he compare this bill to the Nuremberg laws. He simply suggested that if the government has its way, it will set a precedent for even much worse laws to be under the effect of the notwithstanding clause. Now, the scandal started actually earlier in the case when a few journalists, and here's where the cynicism comes in, a few journalists started following Azim to try to catch him violating COVID restrictions. And he did not. As soon as a reporter heard the word Nuremberg, they immediately contacted two Jewish organizations. They told these two organizations this lawyer equated the Nuremberg laws with Bill 21, which he did not do. But they said this to these two organizations. And they asked these two organizations to denounce Azim for this equalization, which they did publicly, without reading what he actually said. It is a sad fact of modern life, and it is an embarrassment to these two Jewish organizations to willingly fault someone before learning the facts. There's an essay in today's Montreal Gazette written by Greg Borden, a friend and colleague of Azim. I have to give credit to Greg for introducing me to Azim. And much of what I'm sharing with you comes from Greg's essay. I urge you to read it. It is, like everything Greg does, cogently argued and forcefully presented. It's an important lesson for all of us. We have few enough friends already, and more than enough enemies already. We don't need to fabricate our friends into enemies. And before we criticize anyone, we must confirm that what we criticize actually happened. I stand with Azim Hussein. These two Jewish organizations owe him an apology and owe him gratitude for the work he is doing protecting our rights in Quebec. My friends, I want to wish you a great day. I look forward to seeing all of you soon in person.